Final Fantasy: The Spirits Within is a historic film in more than one sense. Firstly, it made history by being the first photorealistic computer animated feature film, and secondly, it marked a huge turning point for the Final Fantasy franchise itself, the film's commercial failure being one of the reasons Hironobu Sakaguchi, the director of the film and the original creator of Final Fantasy, left the series. Sadly, the film wasn't just a commercial flop, however, since it also received fairly negative reviews, not only from critics and general audiences alike, but also from long-time Final Fantasy fans, the fan base having mostly disavowed the film as a part of the larger Final Fantasy canon. But does Final Fantasy: The Spirits Within truly deserve to fall by the wayside of film history, and does the film truly betray the legacy of the Final Fantasy series, as some fans might have you believe? Hello everyone, I'm Nokke from Birds of Play, and in this video, we're going to be taking a look back at Final Fantasy's first venture into the world of cinema, determining how well it has stood the test of time, as well as to what extent it should be viewed as an integral part of the legacy of the Final Fantasy series. If you end up liking the video, or if you just like Final Fantasy in general, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and join the Birdhouse, becoming a part of our growing Final Fantasy family. But without further ado, let us see whether Final Fantasy: The Spirits Within actually has some spirit. Say what you will about Final Fantasy: The Spirits Within, but the film is a true technological marvel, delivering some of the best computer-generated visuals of its time, that to the film's credit, still hold up today, mostly at least, even though they are of course somewhat outdated. The influential film critic Roger Ebert praised the film as a technological milestone, and even though he wasn't quite sold on the film's story or narrative, he hoped that other films would be made in its image. In this sense, Final Fantasy: The Spirits Within might be said to represent an opportunity for an alternative film history, or a road not taken, wherein the hypothetical success of the film might have invaded the mainstream and spawned other similar computer-generated films. The people behind the film were also keenly aware of this possibility, Aki Ross, the main protagonist of the film, being marketed as the world's first computer-generated virtual actress, with the hope that her heavily detailed character model would make appearances in other films down the line, similar to a real flesh-and-blood actor. But even though the film deserves a lot of praise for its computer-generated visuals, it sometimes feels like it doesn't take full advantage of the medium to deliver visually interesting imagery, much like the Final Fantasy series has often been known for. For one thing, the film features a very monotonous color palette, with various shades of grey and brown frequently dominating the frame, making it look more like a gritty first-person shooter than anything with the word fantasy in its name. Secondly, the camera work does very little to leverage how the film was actually made. Over the course of the history of cinema, we have seen how new technology, such as smaller and more easily adaptable cameras, have left a huge impression on the development of cinematography. But even though CGI has the potential to liberate the camera like never before, Sakaguchi seems mostly content to replicate familiar shots. Now, speaking of replicating, the film could be said to attempt to replicate a more generic Hollywood aesthetic, resulting in a fairly basic-looking sci-fi fantasy film. This is kind of like someone making amazing artworks in Excel or Paint. Sure, it can be very impressive and interesting to think about, but it makes things a lot more difficult than they have to be. So this seems like a lot of effort to make something that might just as well have been made with more conventional means, although that might also be the point. The film brings the Final Fantasy series more down to earth, literally even, since the story is set on Earth in the not-so-distant future, as opposed to in a fantasy universe like the vast majority of Final Fantasy properties. For fans of Final Fantasy, this might seem like a strange move, although it's not totally unprecedented, since it's well known that one of Sakaguchi's concepts for the original Final Fantasy VII back in the day was a detective story that took place in modern New York City. Seeing New York featured so prominently in the film can therefore actually be seen as a slight nod to the history of Final Fantasy and Sakaguchi's work on the series. Such a small gesture, however, isn't very likely to convince most Final Fantasy fans that the film is in fact a true Final Fantasy, and not just an attempt to capitalize on the Final Fantasy name. Thankfully, however, there are other commonalities between the film and the games, especially those that Sakaguchi had the biggest influence on. For example, we can see a preoccupation with space and aliens that is sort of atypical for the fantasy genre, even though it feels a lot more at home in a film like Final Fantasy The Spirits Within, due to how heavily the film leans into the science fiction genre. More importantly, however, the film deals with the relationship between humans and nature, which is a recurring theme in Sakaguchi's work. The same could of course be said for a large portion of fantasy literature, but Sakaguchi has his own way of approaching the subject. The most memorable version of this is undoubtedly the concept of the live stream from Final Fantasy VII, wherein the planet itself can be seen as a living entity with the live stream coursing through its veins, but is also present in earlier games via the concept of elemental crystals and the need to respect the delicate balance between humanity and the environment. Following the death of his mother, Sakaguchi wanted to explore this connection more deeply in order to help him process his loss, and with the return of the live stream in Final Fantasy The Spirits Within, renamed as Gaia, Sakaguchi expands on this idea and its implications for death and loss. So even if some might still claim that the film isn't a true Final Fantasy, it is at least a genuine work by Sakaguchi that builds on and expands on his work in a very personal and recognizable way. In hindsight, ongoing bitterness towards the film might stem from its apparent failures leading to Sakaguchi having to depart from the series he himself had created and had been a beloved part of. To make matters worse, many believed that the film led to the controversial merger between Square and Enix that seemed to have drastic implications for how the Final Fantasy series was subsequently handled. In reality, however, the film seems to have actually postponed the merger as opposed to causing it, since the film left Square in a bad financial situation and made Square a less viable partner for Enix. Regardless of the aftermath, Final Fantasy The Spirits Within is a film worth revisiting, both as a film enthusiast and as a fan of Final Fantasy. To watch this film with an open mind is an invitation to fall in love with a work that is as flawed as it is ambitious and as extraordinary as it is mediocre. All in all, it's a well-structured film, the story unfolding quite naturally as the mystery behind all that's happening gradually gets uncovered. However, the true strength of the film doesn't lie in the storytelling itself, but rather the medium by which the story is delivered. From a film history perspective, Final Fantasy The Spirits Within represents what film might possibly become one day. As a Final Fantasy film, the film might have benefited from embracing its legacy a bit more openly, perhaps by relying a bit more on the already established iconography of the series, but even without those elements, the film does represent a thematic continuation of key aspects of the games that help situate the film firmly within Sakaguchi's body of work. This means that familiarity with Final Fantasy is necessary in order to understand the full extent of Sakaguchi's vision for the film. At the same time, familiarity with the film helps us see the games that came before it in a new light, making it an important puzzle piece in the story that is Final Fantasy. Thanks for watching and making it to the end. How about showing some more spirit and telling us how you feel about Final Fantasy The Spirits Within down in the comments below, and possibly even subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. At the very least, join me for some bird sounds. Cuckoo! 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 Nice.